What's up, Houston? Welcome to Who Do You Know, the show that brings you the who's who of Houston. Today, my special guest is Katie Lynn with Katie Lynn Beauty. Thanks for being on the show, Katie.
Hi, thank you for having me.
Thanks for being here. So, me and you actually go way back. When I say way back, 5 years. Just kind of,
it's a long time in this day and age.
It's a long time, yeah, this day and age, with everything moving so fast. Tell me a little bit about what you do and what your brand is, so that people who don't know you know what you do.
Definitely. So my company is called Katie Lynn Beauty, and basically we provide and offer hair and makeup services for special events, occasions, basically anything that you might need hair and makeup for. And then I also have a beauty line, which is called Katie Lynn Beauty, after myself. And so I offer makeup lessons. We go on site, we do parties, we do, I sell online. So basically anything beauty is my...
the opposite of me, basically. but going back, a lot of people know that I produced Run Right Houston, and that's how we initially met, is that you were on the team doing the makeup, and that's how our initial interaction was. And then from there it grew, and then I've seen you progress through the years, now to having your own brand. And you've done pretty much everything, right?
Yeah, everything.
So what are some of the crazy things that you see in this day and age with beauty related that are like big no-nos or trends or stuff like that?
I guess it was really hard for me when the trends were coming around with the really extreme highlight and contour, where it was like face-changing makeup looks. For me, it just wasn't my thing, because I knew that if you were to see this person, first of all, it's not something that your everyday woman can do. It's just, it's very hard, it's long, it's tedious, it's not even something that you wanna do on yourself on a daily basis. It takes way too long. And if you look at that person in person, you're just gonna be like, it's just not attractive. And so that was really hard, because a lot of people, you know, social media is very big. You know, they see that behind, you know, a camera with really good lighting and some Photoshop, and they're like, oh my God, I want this look, because this is gonna, you know, change my life.
Yeah.
No, it's not. It's actually gonna make it more, you know, it's hard and to keep up with. So I was not a fan of that. So I never promoted it. I never would do it. I do like, you know, a highlight and contour, absolutely 100%, but I like it more of a natural way. And I do, you know, all
that
kinds
seems
to of be looks.
In nowadays, it's the natural look.
Yeah, well, yeah, natural look, definitely. But I create a variety of looks for people. Whatever they need, I like to be able to offer to them.
Everybody's
and it's
be different.
Fun for me, because I like change. I like playing with different faces, different looks, things like that. But at the end of the day, I try to give my client what she wants or what she's asking me, you know, what I think is best for her. The other thing was the brows. Like, oh my gosh, it was terrible, because I would have to completely fix these really harsh microbladed brows. Ooh. And I'm like, ah. But you know, now it's, you know, the glowing skin and seeing your freckles and seeing your skin come through and those really natural you know, brows and things like that. Like, that kind of beauty is coming back, and it's just, it's really nice. But it's nice to see, like, a lot of 90s is coming back and things like that, so it's fun.
So I would say the same thing when I was a photographer, and you see editorials and magazines, people want to look the same way.
Right.
And I expect that you probably deal with the same thing a lot.
Yeah. But, you know,
because that doesn't really translate to real life.
No, it doesn't.
It looks good in a magazine, but...
It doesn't. But, you know what? I feel like I don't really have a problem with that with my clients. My clients, they see my work, and or they know me, or they've been referred to me, and they just come in and they trust me. You know, I get the clients that obviously they're like, hey, I'm looking for this. This is where I'm going today, and this is kind of what I need. So can, you know, we execute this? And I'm like, great. But at the end of the day, most of my clientele, they trust me. They know what I'm doing, and they just let me do it. And it's fun. So I don't have to worry about, you know, this, that, and the other. Every once in a while, I'll have a client that's like, hey, can you do this on me? And, you know, can you, you know, adjust this or whatever? You know, I'd like to try this. And I'm like, great. And then that is fun for me, because then I'm like, oh, wait, I'm stepping out of my box. This is fun.
Yeah.
You know, like,
it's
they teach
refreshing.
Me sometimes.
Yeah, it's always refreshing when you have that happen.
Right.
What are, like, your pet peeves? Because I'm pretty sure you got, like, a bunch. I know you talked about the brows a little bit, but, like, not so much the trends, but, like,
pet
as
peeves?
An artist, what would be some of the things that you're like, ugh, I hate it when this happens?
Okay, well, I'll say this. Like, a pet peeve would be if I'm being hired to do, you know, makeup for, like, say, a bride. And she, you know, it's her special day. And I come and I see her, and she hasn't gotten her brows waxed. She hasn't cleansed her face. Like, it's basically I'm having to do like everything. And I'm like, oh my God, what the hell? Like, I'm like, what is happening? This is your special day.
Yeah.
So I guess that, you know, and, but I bring, like, I'm prepared for it all. So I'm like, okay, I've brought my tweezers. I've got like my cleansing, like we're about to exfoliate. Like we are going to do this.
So give me the timeline. Like for somebody that's getting married, like what's, how long does that normally take to get them ready with the hair and makeup? Like, cause people really don't have a clue how much work you have on your plate yeah. when you do something like that.
I
like,
mean, it really, it depends. But what I do is I typically book for a bride an hour session.
Okay.
But usually, for makeup, but typically, you know, makeup is about 45 minutes. Sometimes we do the, you know, bridesmaids 30 minutes, 45 minutes, you know, and we're doing that. Like for instance, this Saturday, we are like booked from 6:45 a.m. to 6:30 p.m. We have about 23 people on the
wow.
on the books. And so, you know, I have a very detailed schedule for that. So for myself and the team, and so we have to follow that. We have names in place and things like that. So, you know, I give out a contract. I tell them, hey, listen, you know, we need to arrive at this time. Make sure everybody's in the room, or at least this many people are in the room at once, and this way we can do, you know, the rotation yeah. because the hair is going to take about 30 minutes per person. The bride might take 45 because we, you know, add in the veil, we do these, and so on and so forth. So there is a schedule. A lot of moving parts. A lot of moving parts. Just like owning your own business. There's a lot of moving parts. A lot of hats to wear.
Like backstage at a fashion show.
True. Yes.
So what's more hectic? The fashion show where you have to do six different looks for six different designers yeah. with 40 plus models? Or the bride / bridezilla?
You know what, I would say because I've been doing this for 15 years professionally, I've never really given like a day off,
yeah,
so to speak. I'm used to it all, I can handle it. So going into the fashion show, usually you're scribbling on a face.
Yeah.
You know, like, so it's acceptable to
By the way,
give.
Justin does an amazing job. Justin's our videographer. He gets the highlights of Runway Houston. He makes it look amazing.
Yeah.
Really epic shots. So.
And I'm sure he does. Very, very talented. But I don't mean like literally scribbling, but yes and no, it kind of is. But as long as you can execute a look, but yes, it's very, you're having your head, you know, the model's head is being pulled this way and this way, and she's getting her props fixed and this and that and the other. So you've got to learn how to work in that kind of environment. And for me, I'm that's easy for me. I can work in fast-paced environments. I can handle the stress and do that kind of stuff. I think I work well in that. But I would say that when I'm doing a bridal party and a wedding party, it's a little bit more fun and relaxed, but also hectic as well, depending on the amount of people. But you have to have more of a perfected look.
Yeah.
Like, absolutely. The looks are very tedious, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Some artists are not like this. I have been known to be very, very, I critique things. I like things to look really, really perfect so that when you see them in person, it looks as great as in person as it does, you know, behind a camera. So for me, you know, I take a little bit more time in weddings and stuff like that, so.
So how long did it take for you to know that you wanted to venture off and come out with your own line? Because that's a big step.
Well, it all started actually.
By the way, kudos for that.
Thank you. You know what? Okay, so the journey really quickly, I'll just tell you. You know, I picked up the passion for makeup when I was 3 years old. Wow. It stuck with me, you know, all the way until I graduated high school. And so as my college job, I literally thought that I would just do makeup as a fun college job. Well, it ended up turning into like a way bigger passion, thinking, okay, no, this is what I love. I like doing, being artistic, doing this, creating and meeting these people and interacting with these people and just, you know, the sales and the, you know, the whole thing, playing with the product and learning the ingredients and why and the skin and just that whole thing. And so I knew I wanted to be in the industry. I knew that I wasn't going to step out of that because I literally thought, okay, I'm going to get into oil and gas like my mom and I'm going to be business oriented, like whatever,
no.
whatever.
No.
No. So I grew with the companies very quickly. And then I, about probably 6 or 7 years in to that, the corporate world, I thought, okay, some things had changed, you know, in life and whatever else. And I was like, okay, and with corporate, it was changing dramatically with the company I was with. It was going from more very artistry to very, very corporate. And then you were working like, you know, I don't want to say asleep, but you were working like that. And it was crazy. Yeah. And so it was taking a lot of the things that you loved about it out. So I knew, and also I was realizing, okay, there's a cap on pay, there's a cap on things you can do, there's a cap on life. You can't get to, you know, you can't do all these things that you would like to do, travel, nothing. So I was like, you know what, I'm I knew I'm built for something more than this. I want to step out. I started realizing, okay, you know what? I can have my own company. I can have my own business. I can do a startup. I've built a clientele. I know what's going on. I've learned a lot about business here. I went to the school for business management, so on and so forth. So I decided, okay, I'm going to prep and prepare myself to leave corporate and then start my own, you know, makeup business, offering my services to people.
Yeah.
And so I left the company I was with for 8.5 years, went to another company that paid more so that I could save up and work. And my game plan was to stay with them for 2 years before I left on my own. I ended up leaving after 1.5 years. So it put me in the industry for 10 years corporate. I left, started my business literally almost 5 years ago this July.
Wow.
And what I did was I contracted with other alike artists that had businesses doing, you know, services like that, so I could build up my pipeline, build up, you know, money, save money, so I can continue to build my own clients as well and, you know, keep that path going. So, you know, I had always had the intent of doing it. I just did it, you know, with a game plan. And then I wanted to actually start a lip gloss line and lipstick line then for my brides to offer them for touch-ups.
Yeah.
But it wasn't a good time then. For certain reasons, and so I put it off, and everything happens for a reason. I built a studio in Friendswood. I grew my clientele dramatically out there. I'd already grown it out in Houston, but I'd grown it out there. And then that is when it hit me, because I was getting a lot of makeup lessons in, and a lot of people, every time I would post a picture or, you know, I did a makeup lesson or I did a look, they'd be like, I want all the products. Where do I go? Okay, go to Ulta, go to Sephora, go to
You're sending them everywhere else.
And I'm sending all these places. And at the end of the day, I literally was working 14 days in a row. I mean, I didn't care. I would have hated it then, you know, working for somebody else, but I was doing it for myself. And so I was like, I didn't care. But I was like, oh my God, my back hurts, like all this stuff. And I was like, I can't break my back for the rest of my life to make my living. I'm gonna have to have a little bit more residual income. And where is that gonna be? Okay, you know what, this is what I wanna do. I've always been intrigued by cosmetics and everything else. And trust me, this was a very scary thing for me to do, because I was like, okay, my client is going to be upset with me because I can't offer the world of cosmetics to them. I'm gonna be offering this. But I said, you know what, I'm gonna go into this and be extremely creative with the line. So there's something that is offered to everyone.
For everybody.
And it's gonna be a really, you know, artistry, but, you know, beauty, elegant line. And so with that, I said, you know what, I'm gonna do it. I started working on it. I worked every day on it for like a year. And I mean, I changed things. I pulled my hair out, and I was also managing all these like
jobs. You look so nice, by the way.
Thank you. But you know, it was a process. And when I launched it, I was very excited. And now it's been growing for the last almost, you know, 1.5 years. And it's done way better than I anticipated.
It's great.
And now there's so many more things that are about to launch with the new website. Should be out like this week that we've changed. There's going to be a lot of changes and things that I'm going to be able to offer to my clients cosmetic wise and everything else. And so it's super exciting, and it's a part of the process. So,
well, it's really exciting. Congratulations on the launch of your own brand.
Thank you.
It's a big step, and I'm really excited to see the progression and the growth of it. What would you say is the big item that everybody is all about with Caitlyn Beauty?
I would probably say it's the magic powder. So I initially, the name of the powder is actually, it's called High Def Translucent Powder.
Okay.
But I have kind of given it the AKA nickname Magic Powder because of what it does. So it's just one of my very popular lines. You'll have to come see me so I can tell you about it and show you.
So where are you at? How can people find you?
So you can actually find me at Dr. Ross' office, which I'm based right off of Kirby. Inside of his office, we have the entire line on there, or you can find me at www.katielynnbeauty.com, where all the cosmetics are sold there. Also, my Instagram handle is katielynn_beauty, and I do a lot of content on there, so I would recommend following me there.
Yes, and you're like constantly working out, putting me to shame and everybody else.
I enjoy it, man. It takes the stress off of everything.
I can imagine.
So it's like I gotta find time. Like literally yesterday I found time at 10:30 at night.
Well, I appreciate you being my guest 5 years ago. Hopefully we keep going and
definitely.
You know, be a part of
Thank
more
you
products
so much
together.
For having me.
Thanks again.
Pleasure.
All right, Houston, who do you know?